You've likely spotted satellites in the night sky, but have you ever wondered how these could actually help optimize your business operations, helping you be everywhere from anywhere? Our first session, as you covered on this, so we will be combining the most comprehensive satellite data available with state-of-the-art AI techniques to show how we can fight global challenges such as deforestation. Yvan has developed Deloitte's Discovery EO dashboard, which uses exactly satellite images as well as AI technologies. And with his extensive experience in the field, he'll take us on this journey. Yvan, over to you.
Hey, hello everyone. Thanks, Anker, for the presentation. Just to present myself, my name is Yvan Renaud. I've been working in Deloitte for 5 months so far, and I'm specializing in computer science with an extensive background in artificial intelligence. Now, I'm going to present to you the Discover EO use case and basically how we manage to fight deforestation using satellite images and AI. Let's start with some key figures. First of all, did you know that the forest covers 30% of the Earth's lands? I find it really stunning number, and it really shows just how important forests are to our planet Earth. The second number I want to introduce to you is the fact that these forests are responsible for over 25% of the world's oxygen. And this number could be drastically reduced because of deforestation. And of course, that could impact the human well-being. Now we're going to start with a quick definition, and I want to define the word deforestation that we're going to use a lot during our presentation. Deforestation is the permanent removal of trees from a forested area that are repurposed for non-forest application that could be agriculture, logging, or urbanization. Deforestation results in different points. First, there is a high loss of biodiversity, can be animals, can be also plants, different type of forests we're going to see after. Second, there is also the alteration of the local and also the global climate, and we will see that it's also impacting the climate change. And finally, it has a lot of social impacts. Also, as I just said, deforestation is the major contributor to the climate change and can thus pose a threat to the survival of many species, not only animals, but also ourselves, humans. To give you some key numbers, between 2015 and 2020, the rate of the global deforestation was estimated to 10 million hectares per year. Basically, it's half of the Portugal area. And second key number would be that between 1990 and 2010, 20% of the Amazon forest has disappeared. And you may know that we refer to the Amazon forest as the lung of Earth. And because of this, it means that this forest play a crucial role in regulating the climate. And then if it disappears, it will drastically accelerate climate change and its impact. So you will have sea level rises, loss of biodiversity, and also extreme weather events. And from those extreme weather events, one of these could be the wildfires. You can see on the bottom right of your screen a small animation of a wildfire spreading from a satellite view. And because these extreme wildfires are happening more often due to the climate change, it has also a lot of negative impact on the biodiversity. We need to find a way to fight the wildfire, but also the deforestation as a global event. And to protect that, we decided to combine artificial intelligence and satellite images to come with a solution. This solution can be used by different actors. And these actors can be like first, the researchers. Indeed, imagine you're a researcher and your goal would be to track the extent and the rate of deforestation for the creation of a report or something that could alert on this climate change. And you want to track the deforestation. So using satellite images and artificial intelligence, you could analyze and provide prediction for the future, some forecast on the deforestation impact. Second, if your local authority, you would potentially want to identify areas at risk for deforestation, but also for wildfire. And for this, you could use these satellite images with also different AI algorithms to give you a large overview of all the country or all the continent to identify from the past which area in the future are more likely to be impacted by deforestation. In the third point, if you're part on an NGO and your goal is to enforce the laws on deforestation that are really restricted, you would like to, for example, identify the illegal logging activities. This can be detected from the sky quite easily, and then you could alert the different authorities to take action on this. Then, if you're now a logging company that want to act in all its right and create a conservation logging activity to be able to cut trees, but also replant trees when it's needed, you could need this large scale analysis to understand more what is your impact on a specific forest. And finally, you could also extend this use case of leveraging AI and satellite images as a construction company. Indeed, if your company is involved in large construction site, your activities could have a bad and negative impact on the biodiversity around the construction site. And using satellite images could allow you to comply with the ESG regulation and to be sure that you're not cutting more trees or impacting the diversity more than you should be. Now, I want to take a really specific use case that we've been working on. The use case would be the use case of Rondonia in the Amazon forest. And the Rondonia is really important because it's the third state in Brazil with the highest deforestation rate. This state is located in what we call the arc of deforestation, which is a belt in Brazil located in the Amazon forest that is quickly disappearing due to deforestation. And it's also hosting some really old forests that we cannot replant, of course. And this forest coverage of Rondonia has decreased of almost 20% in the last 20 years. So we decided to monitor this region using our Discovery Your dashboard that is mixing satellite images and artificial intelligence. What we did is defining two main features. First, the land classification. What is useful for? It allows us to detect from the sky and from large scale areas, the different type of areas that you would have. Whether it's urban, whether it's forest, and if it's forest, is it an ancient forest? Is it something, forest that has been replanted quite recently? Or maybe it's a field, maybe it's water, maybe it's agriculture, and so on. This first feature allows us to have like a global view at some point of our satellite image. Then the second feature would be the change detection. The change detection allows us to compare two images and compare two land classification to know whether the forest has been cut down and transformed to an agricultural field or the opposite, and so on. And this allows us to monitor the deforestation progress and have clear number on this impact. Of course, you will say that monitoring forests from the sky and more especially from the space can have many challenges, mainly due to the distance. The first one could also be the temporal availability. You're saying that because they are located that far in the space, it can be difficult to get recent images. And we found that satellite images are quite present in the space, and you can have like new images, for example, five times a day. So quite enough to monitor deforestation. Second point would be the image resolution. Because the captors are located in the satellite from the space, it can be really hard to track really small areas and to identify specific things that are not large scale. And with the technology evolving, now they're able to have capture of 15 centimeter resolution. That means from the sky, you're able to map one small pixel of 15 centimeter per 15 centimeter. It's as small as a human from the sky. Third point would be the atmospheric disruption. This atmospheric disruption can be cloud, firstly, because between the space and the Earth, you have cloud. If you are in cloud, you cannot monitor anything. This can be disrupted using some specific type of satellite imagery that would use radar that allow us to pass through the cloud, but also we can just select with algorithm the images without cloud. And finally, you will say, if you want to monitor images that are as large as a region with a resolution that is as precise as 15 centimeters, there is a lot of job in data processing, and there is, but a lot of technique has been developed, and supercomputer or high-performance computing cluster could help in that matter. Also, I presented to you the use case of agriculture, but many other use cases exist, such as construction, urban management, real estate monitoring, and so on. Now let's deep dive into the demo. So what you will see is just the front page of our demo, which is just a visual dashboard where you can display the information you want. And what we're doing is we're firstly displaying the satellite images of Rondonia, and we can add different layers. The one you will see is, for example, the land classification I talked to you about before, where you can see the different class of areas, and you can also monitor the KPIs on the right side of the dashboard to know the evolution of the different lands and to see if there was an evolution or not and a deforestation or not. Now you can see that we are seeing the deforestation because we are having a change detection layer, the second feature I talked to you about just before, where we have a forest that has been transformed to non-forest. And finally, to conclude my presentation, I want to say that combining different technologies such as satellite images and AI can help us fight against deforestation, fight against climate change, and help us preserving our next generation. If you have any questions, don't hesitate.